Okay, remember this Gap ad that we showed you the other day? The one that so many people found as racist because they thought the little African-American girl there was being used as a prop, as a piece of furniture. Well, now Gap is apologizing and has removed the ad. Think they apologized for this ad from last year where the African-American girl leans on the white girl? No, I don't think so. And by the way, we also learned that the two little girls in this year's ad were sisters. They're both adopted. So one's white, one's black, but they're adopted sisters. I mean, this has just gone so crazy. Can you imagine, the uproar that's happening at the ad agency, Kat, that created this ad? Probably someone is losing their job over this, and they're thinking, gosh, well, why didn't we see this as racist? Why didn't we? Because it isn't.
Right, and this keeps happening because Gap apologized. That's what people do. If one person's upset, just like these students and just like in this case, the knee-jerk automatic reaction is to apologize. Gap has to know that this is ridiculous. These ads go through channel after channel after channel without anybody suggesting that it could be racist because it's not. But all it takes is one person on the internet, oh, this is offensive. I've construed it that way. And next thing you know, they have to apologize, which encourages more people to make these ridiculous statements because they'll be validated with an apology instead of just told they're being idiots.
Todd, it's like we're just going to have our hands tied. I mean, how are you gonna live your life as a normal person in this kind of environment?
Well, it's true. Look, Gap doesn't make clothes in my size, so I shop down at the Walmart, and we've got our own issues down there. But look, these days, truth is irrelevant. It really doesn't matter. Everything's always about race. Everything's always about privilege. And again, it's this kind of society we live in now where it really is, it's unfortunate, to be perfectly honest with you. And thank goodness for Fox Business that we're able to expose this blatant hypocrisy that's out there.
Yeah, well, we'll continue doing it, and I'm going to rely on you guys as well for all your help. Thank you so much. Good to see you guys, Kat and Todd. All right, coming up, Bill Clinton getting into it with Black Lives Matter protesters while campaigning for his wife. The race for the Democratic nomination getting pretty ugly, and boy, has the Democratic Party changed its tune since Bill Clinton was president. And I'd say, you know what? Not for the better. We're on that right after this.